day, everyone. This is Mary Rose Istokoning, a BSN 3 major in Social Studies of North Soushatan Campus. So for today's video, I will be having my report in Ed 304, George Counts. George Sylvester Counts was an American educator and influential education theorist, an early proponent of the progressive education movement of John Dewey. Counts became its leading critic affiliated with the School of Social Reconstructionism in Education. So Counts in full, George Sylvester Counts. He was born December 9, 1889, near Baldwin City, Kansas, U.S., and died November 10, 1974, at Villeville, Illinois. So Counts was an American educator and activist who was a leading proponent of social reconstructionism, believe that schools should bring about social change. So, Counts has made a book which is entitled Dare the School, Build a New Social Order by him. So, this book is an examination of teachers, the progressive education movement, democracy, and his idea on how to reform the American economy. So, this book is divided into 5 different sections. So George Counts entered graduate school at the University of Chicago in 1913. At this time, the School of Education was influenced by John Dewey and Francis W. Parker. So educators were determined to develop a plan for the science of education. So Charles Hobart Jude was one of the leaders of this plan. And George Counts was a student of Charles Hobart Jude. So George Counts finished his doctorate in education in 1916 and also studied sociology under Alvin Small. So George Counts' experience in sociology made him concentrate on the sociological dimension of the education research. George Counts got his first job as head of the Department of Education at Delaware College. Then his next job was at Harris Teachers College in 1918. He left there and went to the University of Washington in 1919. Then George Counts then went to Yale in 1920 and then returned to the University of Chicago in 1926. So with that, his long career at Teachers College Columbia University began in 1927. George Counts wrote There the School, Build a New Social Order, which is a pamphlet that consists of 3 papers that were read in February 1932 at National Educational Meetings. One paper was read before the Progressive Education Association in Baltimore. Another paper before a division of the Department of Superintendence in Washington. And another paper before the National Council of Education in Washington. The titles of the 3 papers were Their Progressive Education, Be Progressive, Education Through Indoctrination, and Freedom, Culture, Social Planning, and Leadership. With that, George Counts wanted teachers to lead society instead of following society. So the teachers were leaders and should be policymakers who could decide between conflicting purposes and values. Teachers should be concerned with school matters, but should also be concerned with controversial matters of economics, politics, and morality. So George Counts believes that school was an agency involved in school politics, economics, art, religion, and ethics. So if the school was involved, it could either reflect the knowledge, beliefs, and values of the society, or it could seek to change them. So the school, in order to be socially reconstructive, had to help solve problems. So George Counts made this book with a desire for teachers to lead rather than to follow the society. So he believed that teachers were leaders and should have been policymakers, which able to choose between competing goals and principles. So for him, teachers should be concerned not only with educational issues, but also with contentious economic, political, and moral issues. So George Counts considered the school to be a political, economic, artistic, religious, and ethical agency. So for him, if the school is involved, it has the option of reflecting or changing society's knowledge, ideas, and values. So in order to be socially reconstructive, the school has to assist in problem solving. So George Counts argued that school in the United States needed to associate with progressive forces such as labor unions, farmer organizations, and minority groups. The schools could improve society by simply collaborating with those that sought to change it. So if the teachers acted as states people, major concerns would be resolved, resulting in a new social order. So I get here an excerpt, which is a message to teachers. So Counts call all teachers to reach for power, and apologetically, both as an organized group and as individuals. As the most educated, most prolific, most intellectually advanced members of society, they have the responsibility to use their power fully and wisely, to act in the interest of the great masses of people. So Counts instructs teachers to remember that they must throw off the slave pedagogy, to work for his power, as it will not be given easily, and to bridge the gap between school and society. Statement on societal condition and the role of teachers and progressive schools. Counts goes on with the question of the kind of imposition in which teachers should engage is if they have the power. He rails against the extraordinary contradictions in society at the time, much as we hear today. So this includes extreme poverty versus extreme wealth, treatment of workers versus factory owners, getting rich of them and closing factories, machine replacing humans, government officials wanting to deny unemployment, starving children, walking by full shops. But also, he starts anew with there is also hope and promise, and that the age is pregnant with possibilities. He continues to say that progressive schools should not only teach children to contemplate their world, but also to re-envision it and revealed a new civilization. He speaks of unifying all schools with new enthusiasm, with a new central purpose, and which will unify and guide all intellectual plans. Counts is going on with a query of the sort of imposition wherein instructors must have interaction in the event that they have the power. Yes, they have the power. He reels towards the first-rate contradictions in society on the time tones, as well as on today. So this includes those extreme poverty versus severe health, treatment of employees versus manufacturing unit proprietors, getting wealthy of them, and final factorist. And then machine changing humans, government officers locking looking to disclaim unemployment, starving youngsters on foot through complete bishops. But also, he begins of evolve for a brand new with there may be like additionally wish and promise that the age is more on possibilities. So he keeps to mention that modern faculties must now no longer best train youngsters to pander their world. However, they should re-envision it and rebuild a new brand, brand new civilization. So he speaks of unifying all faculties with new enthusiasm, with a brand new relevant cause, and with the intention to unify and manual all Hybrus plans. So his point here is that he wanted instructors not to teach students build a new civilization, to build something new na that will help the society and will improve us, especially the government today.